Hi, I'm Clarice Lockery, and I'm a film critic. Now, it's been a very strange year for films, but I think these Oscar nominations finally put to rest the idea that there have been no good films in 2020. I mean, this is proof otherwise. Really, the Oscar nominations this year, I think, for the most part, are really exciting. It's a testament to the fact that all these material efforts the Academy has been making to change its voting body are having concrete effects. I mean, look, David Fincher's Mank is in the lead with 10 nominations.
Please call me Mank.
This is Herman Mankiewicz, but we're to call him Mank.
Mankiewicz. Herman Mankiewicz.
But look at what came in second place, and these had 6 nominations each. Nomadland, The Father, Judas and the Black Messiah, Minari, Sound of Metal. And this also marks the first time in Academy history that more than one woman has been nominated in the Best Directing category, with both Emerald Fennell for Promising Young Woman and Chloe Zhao for Nomadland getting nominations.
The fallout last week said you were completely hammered and on your own.
And also look at the acting categories. I mean, what a diverse and exciting set of individuals that really represent the best in film this year. With her 4th Oscar nomination, Viola Davis becomes the most nominated Black actress ever and the only Black woman with 2 Best Actress nominations. And there are some great surprises. I love that Thomas Vinterberg got nominated for Best Director for another round. There are also some upsets. There always are. I know a lot of people were hoping that Delroy Lindo's performance in The Five Bloods, which is formidable, will get nominated. And you do have to ask the question, if both Daniel Kaluuya and Lakeith Stanfield are being nominated for Best Supporting Actor here for Judas and the Black Messiah, then who do they consider the lead of that film?
The revolution! And you can murder a freedom fighter, but you can't murder freedom!
But overall, I'm really looking forward to seeing who goes home with an Oscar on the 26th of April. Personally, I'm keeping